Good evening.
Good evening.
Grace and peace to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. God's grace through Christ is offered to everyone, so know that whoever you are, wherever you're from, whatever you're going through, you are welcome here tonight. I want to review, Kathy, maybe you can help us. What are we doing Sunday? We're doing an 8 o'clock service. No? 7 o'clock service, 8 o'clock breakfast, 9 o'clock we're going to have service. So again, so make sure that
but have your Saturday time. Morning they can come at 9 o'clock to help get it ready.
All right. And well, they ask me to speak sometimes. They think I should talk to them. And then what we do is I talk and all of them listen. So would you like to sit with them and listen, or would you like to sit over with the choir and listen? All right, go ahead. Who knows? tonight, this is a really, really important time in the Christian faith. I think for me that Easter Sunday is the most important time that we have as far as our faith goes. Second to it is probably tonight, because tonight, as we journey through this story tonight, we're going to find out that Jesus teaches us tonight what love looks like. So I'm going to invite you now to stand as you are able, and we'll sing our first song.
be seated. And will you please join me in the call to worship? Welcome to you who call upon the name of Christ. We gather tonight to recall the story of the night that Jesus was betrayed. Are you prepared to come to the feast of Jesus, the Christ whose life was poured out for you?
By the grace of God, we are.
Are you able to watch with Jesus at prayer in the garden? Indeed, to struggle yourself to be in unity with God's will for you.
By the grace of God, we are.
Then let us praise God, even in this hour of darkness.
God of all grace and steadfast love, greatly is your name to be praised in all the earth. Bring us to this feast of remembrance with open hearts.
And now please join me in the call or in the opening prayer. Ever gracious God, we gather in this evening hour as friends gathered with Jesus in an upper room long ago. We come bearing the marks and burdens of a bitter and broken world. We come from anonymous places with dry and thirsty spirits. Remind us in the breaking of the bread of our need of your greatest sufficiency. Refresh us and make us whole with a cup of forgiveness. Draw us near to each other in mutual service and closer to you in the covenant of faithfulness and thanksgiving. As the night advances, deepen in us a sense of your steadfast love for us in Jesus Christ, our friend and redeemer. Amen. Tonight we have three readings. The first one comes from John 13, 1 through 20. And now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied the towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I'm doing, but later you will understand." Then Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you will have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was going to betray him, for the reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, he put on his robe, and he returned to the table and said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me Father and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also are to wash one another's feet. For I have set for you an example, that you also should do as I have done for you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. I am not speaking of all you. I know whom I have chosen. But it is to fulfill the scripture, 'The one who ate my bread has lifted his heel against me.' I tell you this now before it occurs, so that when it does occur, you may believe that I am he. Very truly I tell you, whoever receives one whom I send receives me, and whoever receives me receives him who sent him." Here ends our first reading. second reading comes from Luke 22:14. When the hour came, he took his place at the table and the apostles with him. He said to them, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. Before I tell you, I will not eat again until it's fulfilled in the kingdom of God. Then he took the cup, and then after he gave thanks, he said, take this and divide it amongst yourself. For I tell you that from now on, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And then he took the loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he had broke it and gave it to them, saying, excuse me, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And he did the same with the cup after supper, saying, this cup that is poured out for you and for the new covenant in my blood. But see, the one who betrays me is with me, and his hand is on the table. For the Son of Man is going as it has been determined, but woe to that one by whom he is betrayed. Then he began to ask one and another which one of them it could be who would do this.
Sometimes we can seem a little disconnected. First of the month, we have communion, we run through, we grab the bread, the cup, and before we know it, it's over. We remember tonight that this was instructions that Jesus gave us before leaving. This is something really important that Jesus wanted us to do. So tonight, as we prepare to celebrate communion together, imagine for just a moment that Jesus says, do this as often as you do it in remembrance of me. And he means tonight. Let's celebrate, shall we? The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On that night so long ago, Jesus gathered in the upper room with his disciples, and as they prepared to eat, Jesus took the bread, gave thanks to you, O God, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, here, take, eat from this, all of you. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, when the supper was over, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks to you, O God, gave it to his disciples, and said, here, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood poured out for your sins and the sins of the world, that we may enjoy a new and everlasting covenant of peace. Do this in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. O Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood.
By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. I invite those that are assisting to come up. We'll do the whole service. Brothers and sisters in Christ, the table is set, the feast is ready. We'll begin with our choir. Our Lord bids us come. The blood of Christ poured out for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ poured out for you. Would you stand as you are able, and let's sing our next hymn.
Thank you.
may be seated.
Our third reading tonight comes from Matthew 26. Then Jesus went out with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here, but stay awake with me." And going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not what I want, but you want." Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. He said to Peter, "So could you not stay awake with me this 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak." Again he went away for the second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." Again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
We did this with the kids last night. So think in your mind, your best friend. Best friend. And your best friend has run into some tough times. Things are tough. And your best friend says, "I'm really in a bad spot. I need 20 bucks. How many in here would give their best friend 20 bucks? 50? 100? They're in a real bind. They need $1,000. Wow, you really like them a lot. I'm available as for friends. Now let's change that a little bit. Because remember, Jesus knows everything that's happened from the beginning of time, knows everything that's happening everywhere today, knows everything that's gonna happen in the future. So let's change this up a little bit. Let's just suppose somehow through spiritual, supernatural, you can see tomorrow, and that same best friend, you know they're gonna betray you tomorrow. But he's asking for the 1,000 today. You gonna give it to him? I'm not doing that, right? You want me to do what? Just throw away $1,000 to somebody who's going to be rude to me tomorrow? That's why we're having this lesson tonight, pal. That's why we're having it. See, if we stop and think about this for just a little bit, isn't that what Jesus really did? You know, Sunday, Jesus was riding into town. People were shouting, "Hosanna, save us now. You're the best. Here's palm branches. Here's my coat. Here's everything in the world." And by Thursday, as they gather for the Passover meal, Jesus knows 7:30, hour and a half. In an hour and a half, someone dear to him with a kiss is going to betray him. He's going to be arrested even though he's the only truly innocent human that's ever been. Human and God. Remember, human and God? And he's not done anything and he gets arrested. Tomorrow, he's going to be humiliated. He's going to be tortured. And he's going to be hung on a cross as an innocent man. Imagine today, cold out, right? But we've got this beautiful blue sky. And at 3 o'clock tomorrow, that beautiful blue sky will suddenly go dark and black. The earth is going to tremble. And the temple veil will tear. And Jesus will die. Jesus knows all of that. He knows everything that's going to happen. And yet, when Thursday night comes, look at what he does. Supper time comes, and the first thing we need to do is we need to get cleaned up for supper. Out in the streets at the time, they were all dirt. We wore sandals. Animals were everywhere, and animals do what animals do in the street. Some humans did. So when you came to someone's house, the lowliest servant, the youngest servant, the servant with the least amount of skills, the one with the least amount of education, their job as you came to dinner was to wash your feet. Can you imagine a more disgusting job than that? To wash someone else's feet? Yet as supper time comes, Jesus says to all of those, "Here, I'll be that servant for you." The meal has started, and what Jesus is really concerned about is serving his disciples. "Here, take this, eat from this. Let me serve you." And how do we repay him? We go out to the garden. He asks us to stay awake for an hour, and we fall asleep 3 different times. And we want him to do what? Die on a cross for us? We won't even stay awake for an hour with him. But see, that's the lesson that Jesus wants us to get to tonight. When we were talking about our friends and loaning them some money, we reached a limit, didn't we? There was a limit to how far we could go. Jesus says to us when he wipes our feet, when he serves us dinner right before he's going to be arrested and crucified, what Jesus says to us is, "I love you so much. My love has no limits." There isn't anything that Jesus wouldn't do for us. A love that is unconditional and has no limits. Here's the hard part. Here's the hard part. In each one of those that Kim read today, Jesus says, "Now you can do this. Now you can love with no limits. Now you can care for each other without boundaries." And then Jesus says, "Go and do likewise." This is a message that we need to hear every year and every day, that Jesus loved you so much that he would be crucified and died so that we might each have everlasting life. I had the privilege of being with Coletta this morning at her mother's funeral. And I got to tell you, I'm in the hundreds. But when there's somebody that has great faith, it's sad because we miss them. But because of what Jesus did, because of what Jesus started that night, The way that Jesus told us, I love you so much, I'll do this for you. As a matter of fact, there's nothing that I won't do for you. You can have a day like Coletta's today and know that it's not the end, just a transition into what's next. We didn't deserve it. We couldn't even stay awake for an hour in the garden. But Jesus loves us without boundaries. There's no limit to his love for us. So today we can look forward with a happy heart to what's next. Jesus loves us so much. Let's pray. Lord, gosh, we couldn't even stay awake in the garden. We treated you so bad. Lord, we went from shouting Hosanna to yelling crucify you, crucify you, crucify you. And yet in the midst of all of that, your love for us knew no boundaries. You would do anything because you love us so dearly. Help us, Lord, to be open to what that fully means for each and every one of us. Help us to see just what a gift that is. Lord, tonight, we have no choice but to come here and to pray all of this in your name as Lord, Savior, Redeemer, without limits. Help us to love as you have first loved us. Amen. I'm going to invite you now to stand and we will sing our closing hymn. Sisters and brothers in Christ, tonight it all begins. On this night, we are called. We were called when Jesus washed our feet. We were called when Jesus invited us to the table. In those moments, we were called to go out into the world and do likewise, that we might love as Christ loved and serve as Christ served. We're called to remember who we are and whose we are, even when the darkness surrounds us. And it's in that very darkness that we remember that Christ is always with us, and we remember that on this night, we were taught how to love. On this night, eternity begins, and the fullness of God's reign begins to spill into our daily lives. So go now into the world that you might give of yourself for others in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Go into the world and love in the name of the one who loved you until the very end. Tonight, it has begun. From now on, it all begins and ends and begins again with love. Go with God, and God will surely go with you. Amen.